Hi everyone, it's Dwillis, Kiwi Scrapper in New Zealand, or from New Zealand, whichever you prefer. It's a blazing hot Tuesday here, and a day off work for me. So I've got so many things that are waiting to be filmed, and projects I've finished, a couple of weeks ago now, but I just haven't had the time to film them. So I'm trying to catch up. So here's one, number one. Okay, this is a beautiful bottle. It's as you can see, Galliano Black Sambuca Liqueur, and once a year at Christmas my husband gets a bottle of this because it's jolly expensive stuff. I think this bottle here is something like $57 for this bottle, but you know, he loves it and it's his Christmas treat. Now the glass isn't clear glass, it's black, but it's not black clear glass. It's like it's almost like black milk glass, you know, it's that kind of sort of like quality. And I've always thought this is, you know, it'd be wonderful to alter, but I've never bothered doing it. So I said to my husband this Christmas, I said, don't throw that bottle away, you know, put it somewhere safe, because I'm going to do something with it. And the little darling produced another one and said, oh, I kept this from last year. And it was all dusty and cobwebby, and I dusted it down. So this is the one I will be altering. Okay. Now these are about 20 inches tall. So there's a lot of room to alter. And I've done this in what I hope to hopefully looks like a 18th century style. And here we go. Oopsie-daisy. It's hard to film because you can't even see the bottom there. The bottom's way down there, and you can't see the top because the top's way up here. I'll stand it up for the moment and just forgive all the Christmas decoration. I'm filming in my dining room again, and this dining room used to be our main bedroom. It was too dark for a bedroom, so we turned it into a dining room, but we haven't renovated in here. The walls are waiting to be painted, and so everything's just junked in here. Okay, so there's still some Christmas decorations sitting on the table back there, waiting to go up into a high cupboard, which needs a ladder. So here we go. You'll see how tall this is. Right the way up there. Really, really tall. And that's the one that's waiting to be altered next to it, of course. So now we're coming way back down here. May even be more than 22 inches, I don't know. That looks slightly skew with for some reason, I don't know why. Maybe the angle it's sitting. Yeah, because it's at the side. So I'll just go up it again. I can't film this in my craft room because I just don't have the space on the table to be able to do something tall like this. So anyway, you see the image is this beautiful lady of the French court, royal court. And what I wanted to do, because I wanted to make this look sort of antiquated, I didn't want it to be all pristine and flat, just as though, you know, like it comes off my photocopier on its A4 sheet. So I've discovered that if I stick things on with a stick glue, like a Yoohoo stick glue, and before it has time to dry, I Mod Podge over it. Give it one or two layers, one's probably sufficient. It actually crinkles it up and makes it look quite old and antiquated. So that's what I've done with this one. And I hope you can see that. It just gives it an old antiquated look, as if it's been laying in someone's, you know, at the bottom of a chest somewhere, or discarded in an attic room, or, you know, hopefully not out in the garden. It doesn't look that bad. So anyway, right, at the bottom. Okay, let's start off here, and I'll zoom in here. And I started off by putting this lovely tea stain lace underneath, all around the bottom, as you can see there. It's one of those embroidered flowers embroidered on tulle, and I tea stained it because it was white. This lovely row of pearls all around the bottom of it, and then we've got this beautiful embroidered scalloped piece. And this piece came from Irene probably over a year ago now, maybe a year ago, in a gift that she sent me. And I've almost used it up now. And on top of that, I've put this lovely tea stain. This lovely, these glass drops. And I got these locally. They're just beautiful. I'd like to get some more. I've got a whole pile, but I'd like to get some more. And they're attached to the Chinese braid. So they've got little tiny gold bugle beads, and then the rest are like crystal beads. Really lovely. So that's all the way around there. Underneath that here, we've got another trim, which has got roses. So that went on there. And to frame the picture, I use this beautiful lace, which has got a gold center. I think that also came from Irene in my Christmas gift that she sent me, bless her. Thanks, Irene, and hi. And here we've got flat back pearls. I put that over the gold because the gold was a little bit brighter than I wanted it for this piece. So these little turquoise flat back pearls that I had in my stash. I've put the same ones on the lady on her. She had a hairband that ends up in this lovely bow, cascades down her shoulder. And so I put the flat back pearls there and put this little diamond. It's like a gold diamond or topaz or whatever you want to call it. There it is. So it looks like a headband with a little medallion. And behind that, of course, going right the way around all the sides, is that lovely crochet lace trim with the flat back pearls and turquoise. Okay, then we move up here. We've got this lovely, I've got a dull gold cord rope around here. Sorry, out of frame. All the way around here. And over underneath that, I've got flat back pearl. No, not flat back pearls. An ivory pearl trim with pear-shaped drops. Here we've got this lovely, sorry, my dogs are in the kitchen while I'm filming this. Got this lovely white lace. I left that white just to give it a contrast. And here, this lovely turquoise gem here, I took off a child's hair grip. It's wonderful. You look at those, you know, you look for that kind of thing. It's really good because they're quite cheap from pharmacies or chemist shops. Here we've got tea stained piece of lace, and that's like got medallions all around it. And in the medallions, I put graduating sizes of flat back pearls in a champagne color. And then I put this lovely cherub, because the 18th century was full of baroque cherubs. He was gold. It was a little Christmas cherub. It's only small. There's my finger. There's my little finger. And I painted him over in gesso and then put some cream on him. Then above him, you'll see in that piece of lace, there's a Byzantine cross. Don't know whether you can pick that out. There it is. It's just part of the lace design. Over that, I put this these pear-shaped droplet pearl trim. And then up here we've got this, oh sorry, I'm out of frame again. Up here we've got this another flat back pearl. I think this trim may have come from Patricia Pat S on YouTube in our recent swap. Oh no, sorry. Oh, I don't know. I think this one came from Jeanette. Seriously scrapping. No, she's not seriously scrapping. Sorry, that's Irene. It's too late. Jeanette is scrapping happy XO. Gosh, everybody knows Jeanette. And here is a Chinese braid and a lovely pale beige colour. We've got some more of these glass crystal droplets around the neck. And underneath them, we've got small chiffon roses. Two rows of those. We've got some more of this lovely pearl here. Some more of the chiffon fabric roses. And then right on the top, oh, I have to go down this way now, if that shows. Oh, my dog. My golden retriever, he's 2.5. He's such a wimp. He's 50 kilos of 100% pure wimp. He's sitting at the door whimpering. He's got other dogs in there with him. This is a small doily. Sorry, my mind's on the dogs and not on what I'm doing. And then underneath that, I tea stained a flower that came out of a lace trim. And then over top of that, this beautiful metal piece. And this definitely came from Patricia in our recent swap. That's Pat S here on YouTube. Well worth a look at her channel because she does some lovely, lovely stuff. It's so hot in here, I'm sweating. Okay, and we've got, and I've got this lovely, this is not a wild orchid craft rose. This is, I'm not sure what it is, but it's came from Irene, I think. And okay, so that's the front of the bottle. Oh, there's this flower that I put on, which is handmade by me. It's a lovely little piece made out of organza ribbon. And there we go, right the way up to the top. Woohoo, we'll reach it soon. There it is. Okay, now the surprise element in this is that if I want to, I can turn it round and bingo, I've got a completely different bottle. Is that clever or is that clever? Well, I don't know. I thought it was clever. So if I want to display it any given time, I can angle it to display it at different on the different size. On this side we've got cherubs, because everybody knows how much I love cherubs, and cherubs figured very largely in the 18th century decor. Here we've got I took this off a there was three of them on a sitting on a hair comb I found in the chemist, and in here there's a beautiful turquoise clear glass embellishment that came from Patricia. Thank you, Patricia. She sent some absolutely wonderful, wonderful things. This little rose here came from Irene, Cersei Scrapping. I love this. This is actually crinkled up a wee bit, not quite as much as the other one because I got distracted. My husband called me and the stick glue dried out too much. But that's all right, I like it. It's lovely. All around here I put this most dainty, it's a vintage 1940s trim. Absolutely so, it's hand crocheted, just beautiful. I got from a friend of mine. And because her mother passed away and she raided the cupboards. And in each one, each tiny crocheted flat, oh, it's not hand crocheted, it's tattered. I put this, these little flatback pearls. Okay, now around here we've got tea stained lace fabric that I put here, and then it's just the same, it's the pearls and the rope twist. I've put a flatback turquoise, dark smoky turquoise pearl in there, and here I've made up a flower. I just did a circle, cut out a circle, spray painted it with some of my Lindy sprays that were in the colors that I needed. And then I just cut it here, there and everywhere to make it look like a shabby chic or shabby, you know, old flower. And sitting on top of that is a tea stained, another flower piece out of a bigger trim I've got. Lovely, lovely iridescent heart with purples and turquoises and pinks in there. And then up here I twisted a dark vine coming from this flower piece, and then it twists in both directions. Sorry, it's just getting so... I'm absolutely pouring with sweat in here. It's just terrible. So hot. There's no air conditioning. Well, we don't have air conditioning. There's no fan going on in here. Here's the medallion with all the flatback pearls and graduating sizes. And there's a little blingy piece in there that also came in as a chain piece from Irene. Seriously Scrapping. And everything else is exactly the same. Go right up there. So that's my altered bottle. I can't wait to start altering this one. Wow, just love them. They are so big. My husband could not believe it when I showed him this. He was just like, wow, that is beautiful. You know, men are hard to get kind of praise like that out of. So I grab it with both hands when I get it. And I don't think they mean to be stingy with their praise. It's just that men see beauty in a different way. My husband can find a piece of wood beautiful and I'm just staring at it, or a piece of machinery, you know, he's waxing lyrically about it and I'm just staring at it thinking, ugh. That's what men are like. Okay, so there it is. That's my great big Sambuca bottle altered, and I love it. I love the fact that I can turn it both ways. So, you know, just thinking a bit out beyond the square. Okay, I'm going to say goodbye for now so I can get out of this sweat box I'm in. That's what it feels like. Okay, thanks for watching, everybody. Bye for now.